98online.com/livewire.
Bucky Lasek hanging out with us. He has three beautiful daughters, and he'll be at the Dew Tour in Ocean City starting tomorrow, and then it rolls through the entire weekend. And this is the third year it's been in Ocean City?
Third year, and it's free.
Yeah.
Look at that. You can just roll up to the beach. So that's where they're setting all the ramps up. All the big stuff is right there with the ocean. That's amazing.
Yep.
Now, Amelia, have you ever met Bucky's wife, Jen?
Yeah, she's been up in studio before.
Yeah. Like, here's what I hate about you two, honestly.
Here we go.
Let's just get it out there.
Yeah, no.
Don't hold back.
I mean, you guys just stay, like, really attractive. It really gets on my nerves. Like, you guys are a great-looking couple, and it really bothers me because by now somebody's got to be ugly in a relationship. You can't be together 20 years or whatever the hell it's been, and you both look great.
Thank you.
You're welcome. It makes me sick to my stomach. Yeah, I look at Piggy and I'll see pictures.
What do you say to that?
Yeah. But you got to listen, I love Jen. I've known her for 30 years or whatever. All this, she's like getting into this mystical, whatever it is, like the new wave stuff, new age. Remind her where she's from, please.
What is she? Is she crushing crystals?
She's trying to be all nice and
stuff. She's getting all new agey and just follow your mantra. And I'm like,
she's big in the yoga.
Yeah,
big.
The yoga stuff.
That's why she looks so good.
And it's more than yoga; it's spiritual. Like,
yeah,
she's got some power.
She's becoming a monk.
Power. She's powerful.
She's got Namaste. Powers.
All right. She does have power.
Does she try to, like, if you're sore, does she heal you? Like,
she can touch me.
And you're healed.
And it's better.
And you feel better.
Yeah.
Where's she touching you?
Yeah, where's she touching you, bro? That'd make me feel better. I'm a fat slob.
Jeez. So,
how blessed are you, dude, with your
Pretty
daughters
blessed.
And your wife and your talent? I mean, it's so great. I mean, knowing you. I mean, I just remember. I remember hearing about you. You were like, because you're younger than me. You were probably. I guess I was 20. You're probably 16. And everybody's like, you got to see this kid, Bucky, skate, man. He's 8 million feet, and I think it's exaggerated.
Yeah, yeah.
He could jump 395, dude. He's so insane. And then cut to 10 years later, and you're one of the top 3-5 guys in the world.
It's pretty amazing. I look back on it, and I honestly can't believe, going down there and skating in Miller's Island with my buddy Ed. And back in the, it was so just, everything was just for fun, and now it's just like, it's.
When did you know you belonged? Do you know what I mean?
Just when I was competing locally, and I was just winning a lot of stuff locally, and then I got to meet some of the guys from California when they came on tour, like all the Bones Brigade. And they were stoked on my skating, and then I went out there, and I was actually.
They just brought you right in, didn't they?
Yeah, they did a demo in White Marsh.
Yeah.
For Reach for the Beach.
I remember it, dude. Yeah.
And I was at the local ramp in Miller's Island skating, and they came the next day or night, and I was there skating, and I skated with them, and they were like, geez, who is this little kid?
You know? Right, yeah.
And I was, I just wanted to rip,
Right.
I just wanted to show what I could do, and I impressed some of the big guys.
Were you... how do I word this? Are you a natural competitor?
Yeah, I think so.
You are a competitive guy, right?
Even back in baseball and when I played Little
League. Yeah, you don't like to lose.
No.
Okay.
Aren't most guys that way, though?
No.
I mean, isn't that like a male trait? No.
And I think...
Most guys I meet are pretty competitive.
I think the greats... I mean, and Bucky, you're going to go down as one of, if not the greatest...
oldest
competitor. I mean, dude, think about it. You have to have more wins than anybody, right?
No.
Professional wins.
I mean, it's up there. I mean, that's
who's got more?
Hawk probably has more, I'm sure, because he was winning.
Yeah, but he was also uncontested for a long time, kind of.
In the beginning,
But I think you'll pass him.
It's possible.
Well, if you keep skating, yeah.
Yeah. No, but I do. I mean, you may go down. My point being, but you don't get to that level if you don't have that drive and that desire to be the best. I mean, you said it earlier, you're looking at kids and you're like, oh my God. And that's just forcing you to keep going.
It is. Yeah. They're pushing it.
Yeah,
pushing
man.
The sport and it helps. It motivates me to see what these kids can do.
And I know a lot of the guys that over in Miller's Island that you ran with back in the day.
Yeah.
And, coming from that area and that community, because I live over in Edgemere now, and I see all those kids out there boarding, and they're really proud of you, and they follow in your footsteps to a certain degree. And coming from that mindset down there, too, that helps out, and having that community back you up.
Yeah, it totally does. And having a place to go, you know, like Charm City right now, I'm sure they're breeding like
it's insane,
street
dude.
Kids,
yeah,
you know, that are so good locally, and they just support the upcoming kids.
Now, is it, I forget what your sport, is it vert what you do?
Yeah.
Yeah. Now, the street courses where they have the ramps, and are you good at that stuff too?
I'm okay at it. I'm not as.
Can you compete with those kids?
Not these days.
No?
No.
And what made, did you just always love the flying stuff, the vertical stuff?
I think it's just because that's what my era, my generation looked up to, you know, the Tony Hawk, Christian Asoy, Chris Miller guys. And
yeah.
They all skated the, you know, vert, and that's what was big at the time.
Yeah.
And then street skating came in, and I was pretty good at that too, and I did that for a few years.
Yeah.
Then I hurt my knee, and I think that pretty much slowed me down.
Is street much harder on your knees and ankles than vert?
Yeah. Street takes a little bit more. The longevity isn't quite there.
I'm sorry.
Well, speaking of street, you've got a lot of that going on at Dew Tour,
yep.
Which starts tomorrow, runs through the weekend. You can watch it on NBC as well if you can't get out to Ocean City, but you should go out to Ocean City because it's really cool to see live. I saw it here when it was at the city for the first year, but out there you've got, you know, everything for the kids. You get a room, you hang out, have a good time, see all 4 days. And the new discipline for 2013, Battle at the Beach Street Session, that's skate and BMX. You also have live musical performances from New Politics. DJ Stimulus is going to be out there as well. And it's completely free to attend. And that's amazing.
Yeah, you can get these premium passes if you'd like to get up front and better seating and stuff.
I got a question. Now, I know that like image and fashion or whatever, it's important in your line of work. I mean, it is to have an image and all that. But you wear your pants where they're supposed to be worn. How do these kids compete when their pants are like below their ass? It makes me insane, Bucky.
I'm
not a square. No. Like if you're in a band or whatever and you wear those low skin tight, whatever.
Yeah.
But you have to move, and these kids like have. Does it make you think dumb? Pull your pants up, and it won't restrict you.
It's a little restricting. A lot of the street skaters don't do that anymore.
They figured it out.
Some of the BMX guys still run it.
Yeah.
You know, the tight pants.
Snowboarders.
Saggy tight pants.
Yeah. Snowboarders will wear their pants down past their butt.
It's just this youth thing. You know.
It's that youth thing.
Those kids. These damn kids.
You can go to the website. There's a couple of them, actually. But if you're looking for the premium passes, you can go to dewtour.com. You can go to ticketmaster.com as well. But, hey, why not just hang out by the ramps and be on the beach and see it for absolutely free and take the kids?
And I do want to say, and we're going to come back after news and talk to you more, but your wife also ruined the Brazil games for me. I'm going to tell you why. Because I had to leave and go to an appearance. So I was DVRing it, and I was going to watch it when I got back. And, of course, as soon as you won, she had to tweet it. Oh, my God, Bucky wins. And I look at it, and I'm like, son of a bitch.
Yeah.
Now I can't watch it because I already knew.
What are you doing looking at Twitter?
Well, it just pops right up on my phone.
Yeah, you need to turn that
off. Forgot to turn it off.
Yeah.
Just turn it off and put the phone away.
Damn. Yeah.
It's like my buddy with the Orioles
game. I think this is the run that puts him over. Yeah, it's the. Yeah, we're watching you skate.
Yep.
Here, you got a trick coming up right here. What is this? No, I missed
That's
it.
That's me popping out.
Yeah. All right, more with Bucky after this. StudyItOnline.com.